Who is Palmer Wells? Palmer Wells, pretty simple kid, you know. I grew up in a small, very small town, farming town, known for potato farming and the Honda plant. I only went to one elementary school, one high school, one university, and then moved into Vancouver for more film school. I feel like there's two Palmer Wellses, which is probably pretentious to say. Palmer Wells III largely ties to my creative endeavors. At first, I added the third because I thought it sounded cool, which it does. But when I came to Vancouver, and I had already kind of been doing Palmer Wells III before that, it's kind of stuck with people in my class for some reason. So what kind of started off as a joke kind of became a nickname, maybe? Something people called me sometimes. So then when I started to make more and more content, you know, I started to think, well, that'd be a cool name to kind of go by because, you know, it's unique. It's something that might linger in the ear a little bit longer than a name without the third at the end. And I've started using it as my credits and the things I make. I noticed your handshake lacked its usual strength. You're nervous.
I thrive off nervousness. Use it to my advantage.
You mustn't mistake your arrogance for confidence, dear friend. It will get the best of you. Yeah, I feel like all these times that I'm acting in my own movies, I think it is the same character, or the same characteristics at least. You know, in order for me to act, I need to kind of just do an extension of myself because, you know, I'm not an actor. I don't have range. I can't do stuff like that too well. But I can play myself. The extension of Palmer Wells is Palmer Wells III. It's like this kind of gimmick that this is what people see, this is what's presented to an audience. That's when Palmer Wells III kind of takes hold and is like, Palmer, chill, I got this. You know, camera is a very intrusive thing. And if I kind of feel that around me, then I need to kind of be playing a character. This is as close to Palmer Wells as maybe a camera I've captured because, you know, I'm not playing a character or reading lines, I'm just speaking. But I feel like even now, it's Palmer Wells III because, you know, I know people are gonna see this and hear what I'm saying. So I feel like because of that, because I'm kind of careful what I say and how I say it, that might be Palmer Wells III. Palmer Wells III ends when I walk through the front door of my home. You know, Palmer Wells starts when I'm just in my own space. My most comfortable, probably even my most vulnerable, because if I'm vulnerable in a situation, you know, I'm not thinking about how I'm acting or what I'm doing, I'm just, you know, reacting in real time. That's Palmer Wells. It's probably the best way I can describe it. I think, at least I'd like to think deep down, you know, I think I'm a genuine, sincere person, even though we've just been talking about me playing a character. You know, that character I'm playing, it's still me. It's just like we've been saying, an extension of me. You know, everything I say and do, you know, it is genuine. And it is sincere. And I feel like I'd want my art to kind of translate that. You know, I still want it to be kind of grounded in something, because I am. We all are. There's two Palmer Wellses. But I think there's two anybodies. You know, there's one that, you know, kind of everyone else sees. the image you want to portray. Then, you know, there's the other one, you know, the person that's kind of roams around behind closed doors. So, you know, I don't think I'm unique in that way. I think, you know, everyone's like that. There's two sides to every person, no matter how authentic you want to be. And that's okay, I think. Yeah, if I had to give someone advice who's kind of doing the same thing I am, I think it'd kind of be twofold. One, you know, it's okay to do that because that persona that's only yours, you know, the Palmer Wells persona, it's okay to have that. It's okay to keep some things to yourself. But at the same time, you know, it's important to not, you know, let that extension of yourself turn into someone you're not. I'm very, very self-aware of Palmer Wells III and how people know that it's an extension of myself. And I feel like sometimes it's gotten me in deep water. Sometimes, you know, maybe I'm taking it too far, or sometimes maybe grasping for attention in places I shouldn't be, which is a problem I have. Because, you know, any bit, no matter what it is, it can get old. You know, it can kind of, you know, people can get sick of it. I only hope that people don't see me doing this and think, you know, he's full of himself or something, or thinks that, you know, he can just add a third to his name and people will believe him and stuff like that. So I think it's important to be self-aware. If you're going to do that, if you're going to kind of operate with this extension of yourself, still be aware of who you are, what your values are. You know, it's okay to be an extension of yourself as long as it is yourself and not some new person entirely. Mm-hmm. I think it's good to kind of have, you know, a Palmer to yourself and then a Palmer to everyone else. Yeah, I feel like Palmer Wells III as this kind of funny persona probably will come to an end at some point. But as a creative entity, if I can call it that, I feel like I'd stick with it. I feel like it's not harming anyone in that way. But yeah, I think there will come a day where Palmer Wells III will have to end.